Look at that sweet little, you saw that kitty cat, huh? And now you see yourself, huh? Well, your kids aren't the only ones howling about summer being over. Chances are your pets aren't too happy about it either. They're now home alone, and many are suffering from separation anxiety. Dr. Stephen Hicks is here from the Akron Medina Veterinarian Hospital with some ways that you can help your animals cope. And one of our coworkers, Tim Murphy, is here with his dog, Smiley. I had read this article in Family Circle magazine called Doggy Downer, and it says that about 20% of the nation's dogs go through anxiety, separation anxiety, when the kids go back to school. And we found that's really true, right, Dr. Hicks?
It is. It's probably higher than that. A lot of people don't even know how much of this goes on when they're away. And it's not just when kids go back to school, it's when work schedules change. That's what happened with Smiley. When Tim's work schedule changed, it's when people move out, it's when people move to a different area, different home. Dogs like routine, and when you take the routine away from them, it creates anxiety for a lot of dogs.
It's very real, and some dogs even act out, you say, in ways that aren't good, maybe destroying property or going to the bathroom and where they're not supposed to go.
Exactly. Some of these dogs, they don't do much more than pace, whine, bark, do things that we're not even aware of unless we put a camera on them.
So that's what happened here with Tim. What a story. We were talking about it in the newsroom, Margaret Dake and I, the producer, about this article, and then Tim, we started talking about your shift change. Tell everyone what happened. You didn't even know really there was a problem until your neighbor told you.
Right. I have this web camera, and I frequently check in on her no matter what shift I'm working on, but when I switched shifts that week in May, I noticed on Monday she was anxious. She wasn't sleeping. Normally she sleeps when I'm at work. And that first day she wasn't. She was off the couch, to the window, to the door, you know.
Just looking for you.
Looking for me. And so on Tuesday, it got worse. Halfway through the day, my neighbor called and said, "Smiley's howling. Is everything okay over there?" And I said, "Well, I'm at work." I said, "She's howling?" I said, "I've never heard her howl."
And you've had her for years. You rescued her.
Right. So I turned the microphone on and the camera. And sure enough, she was howling, and I was like, oh, wow, that just
made
me
right?
feel bad because she was so upset that she's howling.
You can let her go if she wants to run around smiling. So actually then, you went out to the store the other night, right, and took video?
Yes, the other night, when I got home from work, I just ran an errand real fast. I fed her, let her out, and just took off for 20 minutes. I just flipped on the camera and recorded to see what she would do, and that's when I recorded her howling.
So here's this. This is Smiley when Tim ran out for 20 minutes to go to the store. It's just heartbreaking. What did you think, Tim, when you saw this? You didn't even know she howled.
No,
you've had her for years,
and that's what she does. I've had her for years. 4 years at that point, I'd never heard her howl. I didn't know she howled. So at that point, I knew there was a problem. So I asked my neighbor to let her out. My backyard's fenced in. It was a nice day. Let her run around and see if that'll calm her down. Well, on my way home, my neighbor called and said, "I think there's something else wrong with her because she has just gone berserk. She's running around the backyard, crying, howling. And she won't.
She's now in Christie's makeup bag. That's probably not a good idea. I don't know if that color lipstick is for you. So, Dr. Hicks, you put Smiley on medication because that's one of the things that you do in the treatment.
Right. We always try to treat them behaviorally, but that's hard to do because a lot of that takes time and it's desensitizing them to triggers that tell them that we're leaving them. So they will watch for things. They'll look at clues like we pick up our keys, we put on a certain pair of shoes, put on our coat. They know our routine.
What else can we do?
Well, to desensitize them to that, you have to take baby steps. You have to start out by going through the cues, going through the triggers, and let them see you do that. But then maybe you go out and come right back in. You're not gone for 8 hours. So they learn that every time that you do those cues, it's not going to mean them being home alone all day.
Oh, and then you always come back.
Yeah. So you're teaching them that these aren't bad cues necessarily. Sometimes these cues happen and you don't leave. But that takes time. And for the average pet owner, it's hard to go through all those steps. So the medications we can put them on will help with the anxiety, bring the anxiety level down, and then they respond to those training cues better for us. but they really watch those things. And so by doing those things in situations when we're not leaving, it helps. The other thing that's really important is not giving in to what they're seeking, which is the attention. So one of the things we tell owners when pets have separation anxiety, before you leave, don't build it up into a big deal, because that's what they're looking for. They want the attention, and that's what we give them. We talk to them, we give them treats, we make a big fuss over them, and in reality, what we need to do to desensitize them is ignore them.
Oh, and that's so hard. That's so impossible, right?
It's really hard to do.
You feel bad you're leaving them at a different time of day. So you're saying you should just walk out of the house.
Right. For 30 minutes before you leave, don't give them any attention. Ignore them. Let them settle down and not build up all that energy right up until you leave, because then you leave and they're anxious.
Wow, this is like, it's like we've really just scratched the surface. I was going to read, but we're out of time. Some great viewers, I posted that on my Facebook page and had so many stories from our wonderful viewers who shared pictures too, saying, my dog does that too. When the kids leave for school, they sit at the door till the kids come home. So they're going through all that sadness too. Well, Smiley, thank you, Tim, for being Smiley. She's darling, Dr. Hicks, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you for both being here.